Good morning, everyone. Really good to see you. Hope you're doing really well. this is my last ever daily thoughts. Oh no. I said that before, mind, and we carried on, kept doing more daily thoughts and different thoughts and ideas around it. So today is coming up to the end of March, and we're at the end of Ephesians chapter 6 and verse 18 through to 20. And this morning I've got my Pray hoodie on, which I'm really pleased about, and it says on the side, "If my people," and Jackie and I went wild last year and we both bought the same hoodies. So Jackie's got one as well, which is really, really good. So welcome, everyone. I've got my Pray hoodie on and I'm ready to read Ephesians chapter 6, verses 18 through to 20. So grab your Bibles or just listen if you want to. "And pray in the Spirit on all occasions, with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all the saints. Pray also for me, that whenever I open my mouth, words may be given me so that I will fearlessly make known the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chains. Pray that I may declare it fearlessly as I should." Well, that's such an important scripture for us, especially at the moment, is that we should pray in the Spirit. If you look at your Bibles, a spirit here is a capital S, so you pray through the filling and anointing and enabling of the Holy Spirit. So it's not just a good spiritual feeling, it's praying words that God has placed on your heart through the filling and anointing and enabling of the Holy Spirit. So we pray in the Spirit on all occasions. So we don't just ramble on, "Oh, it's a nice day, I've got this happening." We pray words that are coming from that deep spiritual place of that anointing of God. We pray all kinds of prayers and requests. So if your prayers are very much the same, you need to really look at how you pray, how you connect, and how you engage with God. And then we need to be alert and always keep on praying for the saints. Jesus said, didn't he, to the disciples in the Garden of Gethsemane, "Watch and pray so that you do not fall into temptation." And it's very, very similar. Be alert and always keep on praying for the saints. If you run out of things to pray for, run out of people to pray for, if you're a church member, just grab hold of your members list and just start going through the names and names and names and names of people. And then you start to pray for that person, that person's family, and then that person's world. And it just grows and develops. Paul asks that you will pray for him. Now, we can't pray for Paul because Paul is dead, but Paul asked that prayers are given for him. And I would say that please pray for anybody that preaches, that teaches, that is an evangelist on the streets. Pray for people that speak out the words of God. If you've got time, pray for me. I'd really value those prayers. And that we can declare the message of God fearlessly. That we will declare it without constraints and without any holdbacks on us. And then Paul ends up asking that you would pray that I may declare it fearlessly as I should. So that's it from me. A little bit about prayer for you this morning. We've got opportunities, perhaps more than ever, to pray and to seek the face of God. Don't waste your time. Use your time wisely and use it for kingdom purposes. And pray through situations, pray into situations, and pray for people. So God bless you. Thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you so much for watching. And we are doing some daily thoughts next week around Holy Week. So they'll be happening at 10 o'clock every day next week. So, but they'll be a little bit different, but really excited about what we're going to do for them. So thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you so much for watching. God bless you. Keep doing your best, and I'll speak to you again soon. Take care. God bless. Bye.